receive, you know, support from different outreach partners and different programs and things, they choose to make better choices and they go down different paths. To whereas those who do not, they choose to fall behind.
My role here is to kind of help kids in getting and creating goals and helping them achieve those goals. I like to bring up what I call magic box that most high-income families have, that the access to the resources that you would need to be able to be successful. As a low-income family, I didn't have that access.
My name is Maria Berticia, and my kids are 13 and 17, so I just felt like they needed to be around other kids. Every week, they get their stuff ready. Just everyone here, even at the front desk, everyone's been amazing. And then with Chris, with the autism, it was just hard to put him in anything. And here, you guys have treated him like a normal kid. There's nothing that can compare to this.
It's all depending on the individual kid. The world that I lived in may play a part, but first and foremost, it's just really approaching them as individuals and letting them know that I'm there to listen, that I care, and that I'm not there to judge. When you want better, you'll do better. What is the main thing that you focus on that will help you achieve these goals? Your situation, do you think about, okay, I made a mistake, this is what I'm going to do to not make this mistake again?
You have to work your way to that magic box to reach your goals, but you can do it with the support of people who really care about you. When it comes to social emotional learning, feeling more positive about themselves when they walk into their school, because of not only what I learned in the solutions program, but as well as what I'm learning at the Y.
Hello, my name is Louise Hill. I am the Y Achievers Program Director. What I do here is work with young men and women to make sure they obtain good goals in school and as well as work internships. And we also work on them setting goals to find their way in life. Although I was not directly affected by the things, regardless of what, there's always a reason to why people do the things that they do and choose the lives that they choose. So I wanted to learn that why. I started working for the Y Early Learning Center. And when I worked there, I just found a love for that, and the Y just felt like a home. I obtained my BA in elementary education. But I learned halfway on that God had a different plan for me when I was moved into the crisis room. And I totally focused on helping kids who were going through storms learn how to replace anger with positive, you know, emotion. I was blessed with the offer to come and work in the outreach program. I was like, Lord, this gives me the next level to my question of why, you know, do these youth do what they do? And what I love so much about being in this position is to where I just feel like the whole world is in my hand.
Those who don't get an opportunity to be around positive environments are less likely to make positive decisions. I got that opportunity by going out to camp and getting that positive environment.
I would just like to say thank you.
This has been such a, like I said, a blessing. Everyone that supports the program to make all this happen, I would just say thank you so much, because I just know that they're gonna be better kids, better young adults. Kids would not be doing so well.
There's just more kids. I'm just one. There's more families.